Which operating system is the best for Gen4 simulation? There is a short answer and there is not long answer. The short answer is that you should choose the one that you are using right now. Technically, Gen4 works just fine in Windows, Linux, and macOS. Somebody may tell you that you probably have to install Linux to run Gen4. That's not true. Now let's cover the long answer. Of course, it depends. It depends on many things. Let me just cover two. First of all, it depends on whom you can ask for help. For example, if everybody around you use Linux or Mac, you should join them. It's a great opportunity for you to learn something different. And it's easier for you to ask for help from them if you use exactly the same operating system as your group. One thing I want to mention is that the competition among these three operating systems keep pushing them all to get better and better. So we as users can benefit from the competition. You don't have to feel obligated to switch, but you need to consider that it's easy for you to get help from. The other thing is that what you do with Gen 4 is very important. If you want to do a lot of simulation, you want to accumulate a lot of statistics, then most probably a single PC is not enough. So most probably you need to submit hundreds of simulation jobs to a CPU farm. A CPU farm normally runs in Linux. So in that case, you probably have to learn how to run Gen4 simulation in Linux. But if your simulation is very simple, a laptop is more convenient. For me, I do both. For small things and a quick check, I normally just use my own laptop. But if I have to accumulate a lot of statistics, then I will submit jobs to a CPU farm. So you can also learn both. Know the pros and cons of individual operating system would help you to decide based on the job in hand. So one thing I want to emphasize is that nowadays there's almost no difference between different operating systems. So here I just give you some examples. Well, this is my Windows desktop. Let me log in. You can have the normal graphic user interface here. You can also easily have command line interface in Windows. You can do all kinds of Linux commands here. There is no problem there. And this is my Linux desktop. I see no difference between this and my Windows desktop. And this one is my Mac desktop. There's no big difference, right? You have a command line interface. You have a graphic user interface. It's the same thing. That's why I think there is no need to switch if you already have something in hand. If you have Windows, just use Windows. It's perfectly fine. You can learn command line in Windows as well. You can enjoy the convenience provided by Windows. That is, you just click through everything. Okay, so now let me cover the pros and cons of running Gen4 in Windows. So the first thing I want to mention is that it is very easy to install a pre-compiled Gen4 on Windows with just a few clicks. So this will save you hours in compilation or debugging in case that you have problems in your compilation. I have a video covering how to install pre-compiled Gen4 libraries in Windows. The pre-compiled Gen4 libraries are provided in the Gen4 website. So you just download it and click next, 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 and then you have Gen4 installed in your Windows machine. That is very, very convenient. You do have to do some post-installation setup, and those things are covered in this video. In Windows, it's absolutely okay for you to compile Gen4 as well by yourself. In that case, I have another video called How to Compile Gen4 in Windows. It's not that difficult. It just takes more time than this one. It needs about 1 or 2 hours for you to compile the whole Gen4 because Gen4 is a huge package. So what is the disadvantage of Windows? if you would like to do a lot of simulations and you will have to go to a CPU farm, in that case, this will not help you. But it's very convenient for you to log into a CPU farm from Windows. There are so many tools in Windows for you to log into a remote Linux machine, and then you can perform your work there. So no worries, actually. For me, most of the time I use Windows or Mac as my desktop machine, and I log into remote Linux machine for serious work. Okay, so about Linux. The pre-compiled GM4 is only provided for a single Linux distribution with a very particular compiler. Let's just go there and take a look. If we go to the pre-compiled libraries, you can see that there is only one Linux distribution, CentOS 7 is provided, and the GCC version is very particular. And even if you run a CentOS on your PC, you may not run exactly the same GCC, which means that this might not be useful for you, even if you run Linux. Most of you, I guess you would run something like Ubuntu. In this case, it's almost useless. You will have to compile everything by yourself in Linux. So that's the disadvantage. It takes quite a long time for you to do that. However, as I said, eventually this is beneficial if you go to a Linux CPU farm, you'll feel at home. But to learn the command line interface, it really takes time. It's not just a few days. It takes a very long time for you to get used to it. So that's the pros and cons of Linux. And for macOS, it's in between. It is very easy to install a pre-compiled GM4 in Mac as well. So you can see that there is a pre-compiled GM4 for Mac. The reason it's much easier for you to install the pre-compiled GM4 libraries for Mac and Windows is because there is only one Mac, there's only one Windows. Well, there's thousands of different distributions for Linux. Freedom is what you get from Linux, but that the cost of that is the lack of standard. And the lack of standard makes it hard to provide something that can be shared by everybody. So everything comes with a price.